In this video, we are going to show you our ultimate guide on how to set up new Google Ads account. In this guide, you will learn all about how to create Google Ads account, how to set up the payments in Google Ads account, how to create Google Analytics account and where to find tracking ID, Google Analytics transaction pixel for your website plus global site tag, how to link Google Ads and Google Analytics accounts, how to create Google Merchant account, the advantage of using Blue Instant with Google Merchant Center, how to link Google Merchant and Google Ads accounts. Let's start with Google Ads. Google Ads is a system for online advertising of products and services on Google. Before you start, you need to have Gmail account. If you don't, just register your new account. On the Google Ads page, click the Start Now button. Choose one of the options. It's up to you which one is the best for your future campaign. In any case, you can change it later or you can create a campaign without a goals guidance. Also, if you want to create an account without a campaign, just click the highlight text under the campaign goals. Again, it's up to you which one would you like. The next window that will appear is asking you about the ways you would like to reach your goal. Choose the one you like, then click continue. Once you confirm your business information, time zone, country and currency, you'll find yourself in your own Google Ads account. After you're done with the creation of your new Google Ads account, let's set up the payments. The payment methods available for your account will depend on your country and currency. Without proper billing options, you can't use all the benefits that Google Ads offers. Log into your Google Ads account, click the tool icon, then click onto billing settings. Now you need to choose payment setup like billing country and currency. In the next step, you need to fill additional information like payment method, automatic or manual payments. After that, you are done with setting your payments. The next step is how to create Google Analytics account and where to find tracking ID. Google Analytics is a free website analytics service offered by Google that gives you insights into how users find and use your website. You can sign into Google Analytics with your Google Gmail account or create a new one with a different email address. Keep in mind that it should match the one you used in Google Ads. Once you create your account, you'll need to set up the property first. This means adding a web address where you offer your services and products. You will do this in the admin section. To view your settings, you need to click on Property Settings. Once you're in the settings, fill all the required information like property name and URL address. Based on your property, you get your tracking ID that is specific to each site. This code is then required to be added to your website to collect data to create reports from. You can find the detailed instruction on how to do this directly in Analytics Help. Another basic step before you start using the service is to set up reporting views. Views allow you to create exactly the reports you need. You can set many of them as you want to and customize them to show specific data relevant for you. One such setting is, for example, filtering your IP address to avoid it in the statistics. We suppose you don't want your activity to be included in the overall report. Like Google Ads, you can share your Google Analytics account with others without giving your password. You can also find user management into admin section. You invite them through email addresses and manage their account competences. Google Analytics is also an app you can download to keep your reports under thumb. You can also be informed about the activity through email. Just set your own alerts in the admin section. For advanced Google Analytics settings, especially report views, we created a short guide to all the features you can use in the service. Get all the data in real time. Get to know your visitors. Find out where they come from your site. Observe how they behave on your site. Measure the effectiveness of your ads. Just visit our blog where you can read all about this. Now, let's move on to Google Analytics transaction pixel for your website plus global site tag. After we showed you where to find your tracking ID, it's time to show you where you will find global site tag. Open your Google Analytics account. On the left menu, click on the admin. Once you are in the menu, find and click on Property Settings. Keep in mind that you can always create a new account for your new or other website. Now, we are going straight to the point. In the Property Settings, look at your left side. you will see tracking info. Select it and click on the tracking code. This is where you will find your own personal global site tag. This is the global site tag tracking code for this property. Copy and paste this code as the first item into the head of every web page that you want to track. If you already have a global site tag on your page, simply add the config line from the snippet below to your existing global site tag. Now, we are going to talk about how to link Google Ads and Google Analytics accounts. You only need a few clicks to link the created Google accounts and they will take care of the statistics for you. We will show you how to do that. Log into your Google Ads account, click on the tool section, then find linked accounts. Once you clicked on the linked accounts, find Google Analytics and click on details. In this part, you can see all of your stores. By clicking on link button, you will link them. The next part of this tutorial is how to create Google Merchant account. Once you have created accounts in Google Ads and Google Analytics, you need to organize the products you offer in your eShop somehow. Here, the Google Merchant Center offers a helping hand by collecting product data that you will then advertise. Sign in to the Google Merchant account. Next thing you need to do is to fill all the information. Accept terms and conditions, then click on continue. Choose the programs that fit your objectives. If you can decide, choose skip for now. In this step, you can see the review of your summary. Please don't forget to check if your business complies with Google Merchant guidelines. After that, click on create account. You will then be taken to your account where you have your own merchant ID. In the business information section of the menu, complete the required information about your business. In addition to classic data, you can also upload a logo or colors that represents your business and can be used for advertising. In order to upload information about your products, you must have a verified eShop web address. In this way, Google verifies whether you are the actual owner of the address. To learn how to verify your web address and what to do if you own more addresses, see official Google page. The advantage of using Bluewinston with Google Merchant Center. Bluewinston brings you a unique opportunity to transform your common XML product data feed that you are using for creation of ads, price comparisons or Facebook for the purposes of Google Merchant feed. These products and information will be automatically updated each 6 hours. In addition to storing products, the Google Merchant Center also offers a helping hand to improve your advertising results. In the Opportunities tab in the left menu, you'll find recommendations on how to change your products or campaign data to make your ads more effective. Let's continue on how to link Google Merchant and Google Ads accounts. The Google Merchant Center collects information about the products you offer in your eShop. You can then use this data to create advertising, especially remarketing campaigns. Therefore, you need to link it with Google Ads. To link your accounts, you need to use a single Google Gmail account for both your services accounts. Log into your Google Merchant Center account. In the settings menu, click on the linked accounts. Now you can see your Google Ads ID. Simply click on the link button to link these accounts. Your request has been sent. Now log into your Google Ads account and simply accept this request. You will do that by clicking at the Tools and Settings, Linked Accounts, then scroll down and click on the Google Merchant Center account, Details. After that, you will find this request and you simply accept it. This was our ultimate guide on how to set up the new Google Ads account. Don't forget to check our description, where you will find all the links. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe or watch the next video.